Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Justine Bateman.
Justine Bateman. Oh my God, hi.
Hi.
I'd love for you to tell us what was the impetus for this. Apparently 10 years ago, you Googled yourself, ellipses, yeah. What happened?
So I was writing my first book, Fame, The Hijacking of Reality, and I Googled myself and the autocomplete was Justine Bateman looks old. I was like 41, 42, and I was like, wait, really? And I made the mistake, for reasons that had nothing to do with my face, I made the mistake of making them right and me wrong. And it messed with my head for a longer than I would have thought it could. And but I had to get to the root fears that was making me bring in that idea and making it a belief. And so once I unwound that, I was like, all right, let me look at this. Is, I find it psychotic that we're telling women they have to change their faces. So why don't I look at what the root fears are in society? And that's what I go into in each one of these stories.
This is a universal thing, aging, right? And I know you have 47 different short stories in the book, and they're all true.
Yeah, I took my feelings and experiences on the topic, and then those of about 25 people I spoke to, mostly women. So I just wanted to highlight each one of these root reasons, and maybe somebody who's reading it can go, hey, that rings true for me. I think maybe that's my root reason. And then maybe in exposing that irrational fear, they can get rid of that fear, because it's not about this skin, you know? It's about, I'm afraid I'm never going to find a mate, or I'm afraid I'm never going to find a job, like that.
You talk about plastic surgery being a Ponzi scheme. Mm-hmm. Can you explain that really quickly? I thought that was so intriguing.
If somebody is afraid that they're not going to find a mate or keep a job or get that new job or something, because, and they're assuming it's because of their face, they may go change their face and think that takes care of the fear, but it doesn't. So the fear is just gonna be this bag you're gonna continue carrying along with you regardless of what you do for your face. So in that sense, like, you're never gonna win. Or if you're doing it because of people-pleasing reasons, you wanna make sure that those people that were criticizing you don't criticize you again. You'll never win that. If they wanna criticize you, they're gonna find something every single time. So why not just get rid of the fears and get rid of the people-pleasing? And then you can just have whatever face you want and live a freer life.
I haven't been hooked into the idea that you're also changing yourself for other results in your life, a la a job or a partner. Whoa, Justine, whoa.
I mean, I've had it too. Look in the mirror and go like, oh, I'm getting like, this catches the light now, and there's not as much fat up here. You know, if I did this, it would just, you know, and then I have to ask myself, if I eliminate that, then therefore, what will happen? Like, what will be the outcome? Mm-hmm. And then I see like, oh, that I will more easily get funding for my next film that I direct? I don't think so. I don't think this correlates with people giving me money to direct a film. Do you know what I mean? So it's kind of thing.
These are the conversations I gravitate towards, because I want us to have health in all the right places.
Yeah, and I think it starts, don't you think, Justine, with making peace with yourself, with that fear you talk about internally before you can address external?
Yeah, and you know, some of the other women that I really admired when I was little were the European actresses of the 60s and 70s. Mm. And they had like the bags under the eyes and the hooded eye, you know.
Yeah.
And to me, because they were just exuding this confidence, and I was like, I want to be able to walk around with this confidence, you know? So it's not about the skin. To me, it's about the confidence.
Yeah.
The day I die, I want to be the most confident I can humanly be. Mm-hmm.
Once again, I want to be you, Justine. That's exactly it. You have just got it so right. In here, mm-hmm. Head to toe.
Thanks.
Face. 1 square foot of skin is available everywhere now. Thank you, Justine. I love you. I'm so happy to see you.
Thank you.